pressure mounts on aviation industry over climate change. Paris under pressure from frequent flyers alarmed over climate change. The airline industry says it is hell-bent on reducing emissions, but the technology needed to drastically reduce its carbon footprint is still out of reach. In recent months, climate activists have stepped up efforts to convince travelers to boycott air travel, with Swedish school girl and campaigner Greta Thunberg spearheading the trains over flames movement and making flight stands, or flight shame, a buzzword in the Scandinavian country. The sector is under considerable pressure, admitted Alexander Sunia, chief executive of the International Air Transport Association, IATA, whose members met this week in Seoul. The industry has been under fire over its carbon emissions, which at 285 grams of CO2 emitted per kilometer traveled by a passenger far exceed all other modes of transport. Road transportation follows at 158 and rail travel is at 14, according to European Environment Agency figures. Juniac said the industry was hell-bent on lowering emissions, but the sector is also accused of underestimating its environmental impact, with the IATA chief lobbying heavily against a green tax on aviation backed by several countries including the Netherlands. Often these taxes are absorbed in the budgets of states and are spent on whatever they want, except the environment, he said. The International Civil Aviation Organization, ICAO, estimates that air transport is responsible for 2% of global CO2 emissions, roughly equivalent to the overall emissions of Germany, according to consulting firm Sia Partners. But aircraft also emit particles such as nitrogen oxide, which can trap heat at high altitudes, meaning the industry is actually responsible for 5% of global warming, according to the Climate Action Network, an umbrella group of environmental NGOs. The industry has committed to improving fuel efficiency by 1.5% per year from 2009 to 2020 and stabilizing its CO2 emissions in preparation for a 50% reduction by 2050 compared to 2005. It is a major challenge given that the number of passengers is expected to double over the next two decades to reach 8.2 billion in 2037. Biofuel. Electric engines companies are banking on a new generation of less polluting planes with a stated engine, aerodynamic modifications and fittings that weigh less, among them tablets to replace heavy pilot manuals. However, Sukor Yusof, analyst with Malaysia-based Endow Analytics, told AFP the industry has made progress but that all these technological advances to cut emissions are tough to implement quickly due to the nature of the industry hemmed by high costs and the fact that planes typically take decades before they are replaced. Felipe Cluvier, associate director of consulting firm Boston Consulting Group in Paris, said the constant renewal of the fleet is a major part of it, cutting emissions, explaining that the latest models of large aircraft reduce CO2 by 20 to 25%. But that only solves around 30% of the problem, he said. The rest, he added, can only be resolved by developing sustainable biofuel or turning to electric power technology, which is currently impractical. Several airlines have begun testing biofuels, but production costs remain high and industry experts do not believe electric engines will be rolled out commercially for another two decades. Batteries, today, are still too big and heavy to be used as the main source of power for aircraft, said Leighton Francis, managing director of Singapore-based aviation public relations agency Francis and Lowe. Aircraft today take off heavy because the aircraft is carrying a full load of fuel, but then the aircraft uses up its fuel during the flight and land flight. Aircraft powered by batteries will take off heavy and then have to land heavy, so developing aircraft that can do that without having a hard landing or causing structural damage to the airframe will be a challenge, Francis told AFP. The ICAO said better management of air traffic can help, and a new generation of more fuel-efficient plane designs is predicted within 5 or 10 years. A landmark UN report last year concluded that CO2 emissions must drop 45% by 2030 and reach net zero by 2050 if the rise in Earth's temperature is to be kept at the safer limit of 1.5 C. Cluvier of the Boston Consulting Group said to meet the 2050 goal, the aviation industry must start today and very quickly. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.